talks about back in the day with the slave day, and it shares the history.
So you know a lot about history. Does that help you realize what we need to do now to make sure we don't repeat history? Like, by you watching those historical movies, does
no,
it?
No, but the point is that we really do, and I think that we need another good history that can spread. We need a good image. In most TV shows, you know your Pioneergram, right? Your Third Eye?
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, no.
I'm teaching you.
You're teaching me a lot here, man. You're teaching me a lot.
Your Third Eye, your Pioneergram. Tell me, what kind of show you watch?
Well, I work a lot, so I don't have a lot of time for shows, but I like those like drama series, like Breaking Bad and Homeland and Walking Dead. You know any of those? Probably not. No.
No, I don't. I don't have cable.
Well, let's see. What else do I like?
Well, and you know, like, cause you.
Well, it's good you don't have cable. You have better stuff to watch.
Yeah, and you know, you don't eat that pineal gland, mm-hmm. your third eye. That could shut your whole pineal gland system down.
Okay.
By those certain TV shows, oh. And yeah, and reality shows. That's interrupting us too.
Yeah, they're not so good, right? I agree with you on that. All right, so let me ask you this. You are very well spoken and you seem to know a lot as an 8-year-old. What about your friends and classmates? Do they have the same concerns that you do about violence?
No.
They don't, huh?
Well, I was basically, last time at library, my teacher pulled a video of me up. She pulled one of my videos up, my library teacher upstairs. She pulled one of my videos up. It was the 5 Mix TV one. And I feel good about that.
Good.
And
what do you want other kids to know? Because you know, kids like you grow up and might have some of the same problems that you saw unfolding outside and that you see in your community. So how can you help change it so that kids your age don't grow up like that?
Well, we can't really change it. Unless when we start wanting to, and when we start caring, and when we start wanting to, and before we do all that, first we need to get up and be better, and make ourselves better as people.
What do you want to tell everybody to start doing to make violence not happen anymore?
Well, that's what we're trying to do. We have something called Stop the Shooting. Stop the Shooting. It's about stop the violence and stop the killing and stop picking up the gun. Cause the gun, people think, oh, I gotta get this gun. This is my only option. And it's not. You don't need a gun to always solve your problems in certain situations.
I think you're right.
Okay, and I can understand if you have a gun to protect yourself, but I just want, and what I'm trying to say is, where did the guns come from? Why do we have war? And, like, you know the army, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why do they have an army? That's what I'm trying to figure out. And then they have games about it, like the soldier games and, what's that game? The Grand Theft Auto one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Grand Theft Auto. There's too many violent video games, right?
Yeah, and guess what? Grand Theft Auto and Call of Duty, whatever they call it, mm-hmm. that's what's allowing us to get violent. We're saying, oh, I just shot that guy on the game. That looks so cool. I want to do it in real life. And that's what's making us do it, by certain TV shows and video games that we play. I don't really play those type of games. I play E type games.
Yeah, that's better for you.
I play Create. It's a very creative game. You get to create and build stuff and make stuff. And Lego Marvel, it's a superhero game, but they're Legos, and that's creative.
That's perfect.
I like good, nice, creative games.
Well, I think that's why you are who you are, probably, right? So, all right, one of my last questions for you, and then we're going to get up there and you're going to show me where you're standing. But before we do that, there are people who are going to watch you tonight. What do you want to say to all those people watching at home about the violence that you see in this?
Well, my grandma and my other grandma is definitely going to be watching this. So I'm going to say, hi, Grandma. How you doing? Hi, Grandma Pat. And if Mimi or Rhodey's there, tell them I said hi, too. And Grandma Shelley, tell Eric to call me. She hasn't called me in a while. I miss her.
It seems like you're very close with your family, right? But what about the people you don't know? What about the people who are watching and saying, this kid is really well-spoken. What's your message for them? What do you want them at home to know? And how do you want them to change?
My message is, when you're like inside watching TV and you're watching dumb stuff all day, that's when you need to learn or to know to get off the TV. That's the cure, to get off TV and go outside and do something. Do something. Go outside and do something. Go outside, go to your auntie's house or somebody. Not saying you have to, but if you choose to and if you want to do, because me and my dad almost get out every day. And that's why I'm not so interrupted by these dumb TV channels and movies, because we get out. My dad took me to Times Square before, we always go to Times Square, but I want to go there again.
It's a cool place, right? Well, listen, you're awesome. You might have your own talk show by the time this week is finished. What do you think about that? You might be getting some phone calls. So listen, do me a favor. Did you tuck your microphone in your back pocket?